Now let's talk about the concept of a global server. If you go back and watch the Active Directory replication part 1 and 2, you will remember that within the domain, all of the Active Directory partitions replicate. So we have the domain partition, which is all the information about the users, objects, groups, and so forth, replicating to any other domain controllers we have in the same domain. But let's think about something. If you remember, only the configuration and schema actually replicated across the domains to other servers in other domains, right? So it was only the schema and configuration partitions that replicated across domains. Well, that creates a problem because the domain partition does not replicate across domains, which means that this guy right over here, this server, has absolutely no idea about the users, groups, and so forth in this domain. So what happens when a user comes in down here, logs in, just like always, but they connect to this domain controller, they log in, and now they begin to ask questions about resources, users, groups, or whatever that are in this domain over here. This domain right here has no idea what they're talking about. So what we can do is use a global catalog. Now, the global catalog, we can make these servers global catalog servers. Now, what happens is when we do that, it adds really another partition to Active Directory, and it puts basically an index of all the objects in the forest, and it keeps those replicated between all the global catalog servers. And now, anytime a user tries to connect to this server and get information about a group or a user or whatever over in this domain, it can see it right here in the global catalog server, because this is like a little index of all the users, groups, and everything throughout the forest. So let's go look at kind of the text on this. So a global catalog server stores a subset of information. Every object in the forest is included in the global catalog server. What you need to do is think index. Just like the index at the back of a book, it doesn't store a lot of information. It doesn't store everything, but it does tell you where to find it and where to get more information about that particular object. This is very useful to applications that have to locate objects in Active Directory. Probably the most predominant one that you always hear tossed around is Exchange, because Exchange may have mailboxes that are homed in servers and other places in the forest and different domains, and we need to be able to find those to deliver the mail. Now, the downside to global catalog servers is that they require replication to stay up to date, because they have to pass all this information around. Now, here's the general rules on global catalog placement. First of all, the first domain controller you install in every domain is automatically a global catalog server. All the others are not, and you'll have to turn it on if you want it. And I'll show you how to do that in just a second. But here's some general rules. First of all, if you have a site where an application is performing a lot of Active Directory queries, it's looking for users, looking for groups, and that sort of thing, you need a global catalog server there. If a connection to another global catalog is slow or unreliable, Active Directory knows where the global catalog servers are and will attempt to connect to them. But if you've got a slow, unreliable link, your logons are going to be problematic. It'll cache a logon, but then you'll have problems later on. All kind of issues can come up. And if the site contains a server running Microsoft Exchange, now you notice here that global catalogs tend to be site related, even more so than domain related. So what I would strongly encourage you to do is just go out and read a little bit about global catalog servers and understand, for the purposes of the exam, the first domain controller that goes up in a domain is by default a global catalog server, and then I can make additional servers global catalog servers. And let me show you how to do that right quick. What I will do is, let's go out, we'll click Start, we'll go to Administrative Tools, and we'll go to Active Directory Sites and Services. This is impossibly simple to see how to do this. I will simply go into my sites, and here's my default site first name. I'm going to look for the server that I want to make a global catalog server, and I will just keep expanding it until I see NTDS settings. Right click on that, go to Properties, and you see this little checkbox. Now, this was the first domain controller in this domain, and so it made it a global catalog. If this was not checked, I would just simply check this and say OK, and that's it. And it would basically tell me, OK, you're a global catalog server, and it would begin to replicate that information to it. So you can see there's no big deal in setting up a global catalog server. Just understand, generally replication is not going to be a problem with these guys unless you have a really big forest with a lot of different domains and so forth, and then that global catalog replication can kind of start to be problematic. That's a real quick run through on global catalog servers. Go out and do some reading on them before you take the exam, but it's pretty easy to figure out what's going on with these guys.